This is CSGO running on my low-end intelHD computer. And this is how it used to be. And while CSGO is a super serious competitive shooter game and therefore most possible tweaks are locked away behind cheats, there are some things that you can use to squeeze every bit of performance until you can finally play this game on your low-end computer. This is the LowSpecGamer, where we never stop experimenting on what else we can change to just get a couple of frames more, and where low resolutions are good resolutions. So, forget about decals and default drivers because we're making this game run. These are the default settings for CSGO on my laptop. As you can see, all the graphical settings and effects are on their lowest. There are plenty of resolution options, with 720 being the lowest quote-unquote true 16:9 resolution, 1280 by 600 having black bars on top and bottom of the screen. There are, of course, options for 4:3, such as 800x600. On 720, the GPU limits the game hard, with an average performance of about 29 to 30 FPS. 800x600 does expectedly better, and somewhere around the vicinity of 40 FPS. Alright, so what can we do to get the best experience out of this game? The first two things I'm going to do are the same classic things that you will see on every CSGO video. Go to your game's launch options and make sure to include the following options: High for some minimum CPU performance increases, Not 3D9X to disable some enhancements used to alt-tab out of the game faster, Nojoy that disables joypad support for a tiny bit of more available RAM, Threads with a number of threads in your CPU, Novid if you want to skip the Valve intro video, MatQM mode 2 which changes the mode on which the material system runs and can provide a boost in performance on many systems, and exec autoexec.cfg, which will allow you to load an external configuration file with all sorts of extra console commands. CSGO is supposed to load the autoexec automatically, but in many cases, including mine, it seems like the game will not load the file unless you add this. And finally, you can specify a resolution using W for width and H for height. Do be aware that certain custom resolutions will not load correctly on full screen. You can use windowed as a launch command to force the game into windowed if you so desire. As for the autoexec configuration file, you need to go to your Counter-Strike folder, usually located on Program Files, Steam, Steam Apps, Common, Counter-Strike Global Offensive, CSGO, CFG, and create a file called autoexec.cfg if it does not exist already. The current file I'm using has been provided by Combo Wombo, who also helped in providing some of the other tricks you will see on this guide. I have, however, added some commands in the bottom that are commonly present in all FPS boosting CFGs I have read. And I have also added this little thing. You cannot disable decals completely in CSGO, but you can bind resetting all decals to a key, so if you hit that key during the game, you can remove those decals for a bit of extra performance. Some other users have also recommended this one, which will also be linked in the description for you to try. It is also a really good idea to use the echo command to show some easy to recognize text to the console at the start of the file. That way, when you start the game, you can assign a button to the console and open it to make sure the file has been read. If it is not working, you can manually execute it by typing exec autoexec. There are plenty of FPS boosting configs out there, so be sure to let me know your favorite ones in comments so I can check them out. Right, that's that. Now, we're going to do something interesting with drivers. We are going to be using PHDGD. These are alternate drivers for Intel HD GPUs that are made to squeeze every bit of performance possible in some games. So I turned up the game to 720 to make sure the GPU was limiting performance and ran the benchmark several times on both official and PHDGD drivers, and there's an actual important performance difference. If you're interested in installing drivers and giving it a try, check out the Integrated Graphics Survival Guide, where I go into detail on this and some other methods for getting the best performance out of Intel HD GPUs. If you're playing at a lower resolution and being limited by CPU, it might also make sense to go into your program manager and manually change the priority of CSGO process to high. I know this is the kind of performance tip that gets thrown around on many games, and that it usually doesn't work, but after limiting the resolution to 800x600 and running the benchmark many times on several priorities, there is a small but definite difference on performance when running the game on the high priority. Hey, I did say that for this game, we were going to squeeze everything we can out of unconventional methods. Let's see how it goes. So what happens when a non-Counter-Strike player tries his luck at this game? Let's see.
Fuck!
Whoa, that was quick. Right, this time I'm going to stay with the group. My logic is that if we're all crappy in a group, we are going to be at least paceable, I guess. Oh, we got one, we got one. Haha, yes. Yeah, woo! I'm actually doing something. I'm always amazed by the never-ending popularity of this game. How long has this version of Counter-Strike been out? And still, it's one of the things people request the most, it's one of the things that people play the most. The popularity of this game is... wow! Okay, well, that was... not good. Oh, I almost got him. Oh, he ran away. Oh, he's there. Come on, come on. They hunt the sun! Come on, come on! Oh, well, that was a... never mind. Feel free to leave in comments all the things that I'm evidently doing wrong and that I should obviously do to increase my ability to play this game. If experience is anything to go by, you don't need my permission to do it. Oh, what? Oh, well. Wow, what a mess. At the very least, my performance seems to be doing nice, right? Oh, come on! Yeah, I guess there was just some body shots. Oh. Hey, at least the performance is doing pretty nice for the amount of action that is going on. Ooh, smoke. So this is an excellent opportunity to test, because smoke usually slows down my computer. And check it out. It's actually doing pretty well, especially compared to where, how it was going during the benchmark. Fantastic. Oh, fuck. Okay, we are in trouble, fellas. Oh, did I actually got one? Yep, I definitely did. Wow. Oh, okay. That's definitely not the direction I want to go. How did I not kill that guy? Jesus Christ, how is that even possible? Fuck, 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 fuck. 5-year veteran coin. Why am I playing with this, guys? This is not good, guys. This is... damn it. How am I not dead? Ah! What? Who killed me? How? Why? When? Is that even possible? What the hell? What a mess. Performance is fine for all the mess that's going on. Was so close. I could have just thrown him a flashbang. It wasn't even the guy I was chasing, it was some other dude. Ah, come on, dude, come on! I just started. There are some commands that can be used to graphically downgrade this game quite dramatically, but they require cheats, so they will be usable only on LAN or in servers that allow it, if such a thing exists. In any case, that's a topic for another video. Oh, and if you want to see the full version of this gameplay, make sure to check my gameplay channel. Thank you to all the Patreon contributors for helping me out on my quest to keep this channel going. Remember that your help is very important. With your help in Patreon or simply by liking or commenting, I can do my best to keep making videos. And finally,
LowSpecGamer giveaway.
This was the question asked on the last video, and the winners are JJ, and you should get yourself that darn Nerf gun someday, Cesar Alberto Rebasa Canales, M. Grev, Caseflat, and M515. Congratulations. This time, I'm bringing what is sure to be an interesting question. What will be the most hilarious game if played competitively? This time, we're going to do something a little bit different. I'm going to pick 5 winners at random from all the comments, tweets, Facebook comments, and Steam group answers of the questions and give out these games in order of how the winners are picked. The grand prize is a key for CSGO, so you can try this out. Thank you to all the game donors. See you on the next video. Did you expect any sort of clever commentary when playing this game? Not gonna get much, I'm afraid.